With a word explosion welcome, please make some noise for my brother, Pastor Micheal Todd.
Word explosion, let's give God a big shout of praise in this building. Hold on. They told me I was in Nigeria and there was no place that the praise went up like it did in Lagos, Nigeria. So I'm going to give you 5 seconds to lose your dignity, forget about what you put on today, and give our God. I said give our God a big shout of praise in this place. We honor you, God. We lift you up. We magnify you. There's nobody like Jehovah. Hallelujah. The music stopped, but your praise shouldn't have. You in the balcony, you better stop acting bougie. Hold on. No music. Worship our God. We're shifting the atmosphere right now. Let it rise. Father, take over this place. Heal, deliver, and set free. Ignite us to a new, fresh anointing. I feel something about to happen in this place tonight. See, if you came in this place tonight, you came with an expectation. And I don't care how young you are or how seasoned you are. You see, I didn't say old. Seasoned. I want you to know that God has a specific plan for your life. And he didn't bring me here all the way from Tulsa, Oklahoma to give you another message. I'm here sent on assignment to pull you into the future. You listen. Jimmy, tonight, I'm not going to give you a cute message to help you feel better about your situation. Tonight, I'm about to yank you into the future that God has. I'm telling you, everybody that has the ear to hear it tonight, tonight is going to change generational patterns of thinking. Tonight is going to move you out of complacency into contentment in what God has given you. Tonight, some of you are not going to need your situation to change because your perspective is about to change. And so what I found out is that my God responds to how I react before he gives me the blessing. When you praise God before you get the answer, it's called faith. When you worship God before you get the money, it's called faith. When you give God all the glory he deserves before he changes the situation, it's called faith. So your measure of worship and praise dictates how you believe God is about to show up in your situation. So little praise, little miracle. What you want to happen in your... Oh! I dare you to give God the... Oh! I dare you to give... Let praises rise. Let praises rise. From the front to the back, the north and the south. Let praises... Somebody's about to get a breakthrough. I'm trying to control myself because this is my first time here and I want to come back. But tonight, generational patterns are about to be shifted. Things your mama couldn't break off of you tonight. There's some generational things that. But our expectation has to be one that God can do anything. Not just for Pastor Jimmy, not just for the pastor. Somebody say, God can do it for me. You didn't say it with no faith. Somebody say, God can do it for me. If you're watching online, one more time, say, God can do it for me. I got 100 people that believe it. But one more time, with all the faith that you got, God can do it for me. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I'm gonna need a towel. I'm gonna need a shower. I'm gonna need everything after this. I bring you greetings from Tulsa, Oklahoma, in the United States of America. And today, I'm just overwhelmed by the sovereignty of God that I would be standing here before you in this capacity. I'm a regular guy who's messed up a whole bunch, but if not for the grace of God, he found me, he saw me, I said yes, and God has done some amazing things, and I got to cross paths with your pastor. Before he was calling himself Pastor Jay, but he wasn't really a pastor back then. And we got to connect, and there was just a deep bond. You may not know this, but the church that both of your pastors went to while they were studying at Oral Roberts is the founding church, Greenwood Christian Center, that now is Transformation Church. So we come from the same blood when it comes to ministry. And when Pastor Jimmy reached out, I didn't see the message. I'm not supposed to be here right now. Except the Holy Spirit told me one day, he said, go look in your messages. And this was just 2 or 3 weeks ago. And I looked at my message and said, Jimmy Odekoya, what's up? What Jimmy doing? And he had invited me to the conference, and we were too close. And I asked my wife, and I was like, do you think this is, I started to pray about it. And the Holy Spirit put a demand on me. He said, you are supposed to be in Africa on this date. And I was like, Lord, I ain't been to Africa in a long, long time. Why am I supposed to be there? He said, because there is going to be a divine appointment of people to be shifted. And you're the one to do it. I hit Jimmy back. And all the doors that were closed to get visas and do all this stuff, everything just opened up. And I want you to know that God has moved mountains. Y'all just sang it? So that you could get this word tonight. So are you ready for what God is about to do in this place tonight? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I can't start without honoring my parents are here. Pastor Tommy and Brenda Todd that are here. I would not be here today without you guys, and I appreciate you. They came, once they found out I was coming to Africa, my mama said, I'm coming to pray. Y'all heard her last night. This is the stock I came from, and we have a beautiful team that's come with us, and I'm grateful for all of them. Can y'all give God praise? And then my baby mama is here, y'all. My wife, come here for 1 second. Just come here. I'm not gonna make you say nothing. This is her first time in Africa, y'all, and she kind of love it. Just say hi.
Hello, everyone. Everyone looks so beautiful tonight. We are so honored and humbled to be here, and it's amazing. You know who this guy is, you know? He changes diapers and takes out trash at home, you know?
Way to keep you humble. But I am grateful. I wanted to say in front of every person that we are really grateful to be here just expanding the body of Christ together. And we love you, and we love this church. Can we give it one more time for your pastors, Pastor Jimmy and Pastor Jimmy? Come on, y'all. We love you. We honor you. All right. Y'all done sang all these songs. I got one. Y'all want to learn a new song from Transformation Church real quick? Okay, there's a song, we just released a song called Overflow, but that's not the one we're going to sing tonight. That's not the one. The Holy Spirit put another one in my mind, and I think it will be very beautiful once you get it. It's just calling God one of his names. Somebody say Yahweh. When you focus on him and he becomes bigger, that word is supposed to be mean the breath of God, because when you say it, it's like Yahweh. Like the very breath. Everybody take a deep breath in. Breathe out. That's the breath of God. Right there. And when it says, let everything that have breath praise the Lord, it's a command. It's not an option. And some of us have been in this service with all this high worship, and you still been fighting, giving God what he already deserves. So today, I just felt, I'm going to just teach you a little course of this. You're in the key. It's very simple. It says, Yahweh, Yahweh, reign over and take over. We say, Yahweh, Yahweh, reign over. Oh, I feel the presence of God. And take over. Could you lift your hands and just focus on him? Yahweh. Reign over.
Reign over.
And you can
take over.
Come on, let that be your prayer in this place. Say, Yahweh.
Yahweh.
Say, Yahweh. Reign over.
Reign over.
Oh. And take over.
Take
every situation,
over.
Your job, your children. Lift your hands and say, Yahweh.
Yahweh,
reign over.
Over
everything in my life. I need you to be Lord and
take over.
Oh, I feel the presence of God. Just one more time, say Yahweh.
Yahweh.
We need you, Father. One more part. It says like this. It says, whatever you want to do, whatever you want to do, have your way. Have your way. Can you sing that with me? Whatever. Whatever you want to do, whatever you want. Come on, you're talking to your Father. Have your way. Have your way. Just you and him. Whatever you want to do, say.
Whatever you want to do.
I'm yours, God. Whatever.
Whatever you want to do.
Speak to me. Do whatever you want.
Have your way.
Woo.
Say, have your way.
It's intimate. You and Baba. Come on, son. Whatever. Said, have your way. Said, have your way. Last time we're going to see Yahweh. No music. Everybody say Yahweh. Say Yahweh. Yahweh. Reign over.
Reign over.
And take over.
Take over.
Say Yahweh. Yes, God. Woo. Take over, Lord. Just one more time. Somebody's faith is building. Yahweh.
Woo.
Reign over. Take over this service, God, tonight.
And take.
one more time. Sing that out. Yahweh. We need you, God.
There is a sweet anointing in this sanctuary. There is a stillness in the atmosphere. So come lay down the burdens you have carried, for in this
if you know God is here, would you just give him one huge shout of praise all over this building? I said, if you know the King is here, would you give him one huge shout of praise in this building? You may be seated. My God, today. I'm a recovering worship leader, so anytime you got good musicians and hungry hearts, I might get stuck. Hallelujah. Have your way. Have your way, Lord. Have your way. So many times in church, we try to rush moments to get to the next one when God might be doing something in this moment. He might be healing somebody right now. I don't got to lay my hands on you. God's here. When he shows up, other things have to leave. It's the weight of his glory. Hallelujah.
Great is thy faithfulness. O Lord, my Father, there is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions, they fail not.
Some of y'all too young for this.
But as thou hast how forever will be.
Ooh. Said, great is thy faithfulness.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Morning.
Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
That again.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Just one more time.
Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
I wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. Been tired, lift your hands.
Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. He will renew your strength.
Hey.
So wait, I say.
I don't mind waiting.
Oh,
I don't mind.
Don't mind waiting.
On on you, Lord.
On you, Lord. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting. I don't mind waiting on you, Lord.
The anointing of God is here, y'all.
Take
you want me to preach, but you really need him to move. Just come on, y'all. Just one more time.
Say,
have your way, Lord. Take my heart and mold it, and take my mind, transform it.
Transform it.
I'm trying to move, y'all, but
take my will,
conform it. Come on, somebody say,
conform it.
Say, to yours,
to yours, to yours.
Oh Lord,
oh Lord.
Just one more time, somebody say, take my heart, say,
take my heart
and mold it.
And mold it.
Say, take my mind.
Take yes.
Transform it.
Transform it.
And take my will.
Take my will.
Yeah.
Conform it.
Say to yours.
To yours.
Wanna be like you.
To yours.
Wanna be like you.
Oh Lord.
Father, thank you for what you've already done in this room. Whatever words you want to add to this moment with you, I will be submitted and obedient to speak them. Father, I declare that people's ears are open. I declare, Father God, that when the word hits their heart, it will immediately begin to grow. I thank you, Father, that the peace of God rules over this room. And Father, I thank you that your word will bring revelation to everyone hearing it. In Jesus' name, somebody say amen. Let's give God one more shout of praise in this room. Hallelujah. You may be seated. All right. I got 40 minutes, and I came a long way, so I'm about to open this fire hydrant, and I'm not going to let up off of you for 40 minutes, okay? So I need you to get ready to retain what God is bringing to you today, because I believe that God sent me all the way to Africa to unlock your overflow. Hear what I just said. Tonight is going to be the unlocking of your overflow. There are too many of you, you can stop playing because I don't want them to feel even like this is about to be real sweet. I'm coming straight for you. There are too many of you that have let the culture that you live in dictate the way you see God. Where you grew up, what you didn't have, what they told you has now dictated how big God can be in your life. And tonight I'm coming to pull you by faith into the realms that have nothing to do with where you were born. The realm that has nothing to do with what your mom and them had and what they were able to see. Tonight, by faith, somebody shout at me, by faith. I said, shout at me, by faith. Tonight, I want you to realize that you are a kid of the King. Nope. I need to find a section that's going to have crazy faith with me tonight. Tonight, I need you to understand that you are a child of the King. And whatever has been opposition against you is going to have to bow at the feet of the God who represents you. This next season of your life, I prophesy over you, is going to be a season of overflow. I need you to hear me say it. This will be a season of more than enough. This will be a season that you will have so much that you will have to decide who to bless around you. Your words will flow with power. You will not lack anything. This is your season of overflow. If you believe it by faith, give God a shout of praise right there. Nope. I can tell you still don't believe it because you think I'm coming here to hype you up. I'm here as proof that you can live beyond what they said was possible. And tonight I'm working against strongholds and principalities. I feel you, and I ain't scared of you either. Because there's been an oppression and a depression based on what you have seen growing up from a child. Based on what they told you. And if you get this education, and if you go here, and then this is the way. God we serve, the God we serve is a God that breaks patterns. I'm gonna have to work real hard tonight. This is fourth night of this conference, and you still don't believe that God will break a pattern for you? It can be 100 people that had to do it the same way, but all it takes is one person. Where they at? Where's the one person that God's going? Who's going to see God do something that ain't never been done before? Oh, I feel it. Who's making a decision that I want to see God do the impossible in my life? Somebody shout at me, overflow. Until you believe it, you will never see it. Do you know one of the greatest things that God gave you was an imagination? Because the imagination allows you to pull into your present what is not actually here, but is possible in your future. Everybody close your eyes. See yourself next to the ocean. Uh-oh, somebody just got real excited. See yourself with your favorite drink. Some of y'all just got drunk. Come back in the name of Jesus. See yourself relaxing, all bills paid, all things taken care of. See it. What you wearing? Now look back at me. Many of you just went to another place while you were still here. This is what faith is supposed to be. It's when you can see before you see it. It's when you close your eyes and what is God showing you and how do you look and how much weight have you lost and how, come on somebody, where are you at? Where's your family relationship? Are you married? And the enemy would love for you to just see with what is around you. And tonight I just want you by faith to see yourself living in the overflow. Let me read a scripture to you real quick. Romans chapter 15, verse 13. Somebody say, I'm going to live in the overflow. Yep, three people believed it, but I want you to say it one more time. I'm going to live in the overflow. Somebody got it one more time. I'm going to live in the overflow. This thing going to get strong by the end of the night. I feel this thing. I pray that God, the source of hope, will fill you completely with joy and peace. How many people could use some more joy and some more peace? Okay? I pray that God, the source of hope, would fill you completely with joy and peace. Watch this. Because you, dang, golly. Can't get filled up without trust. And this is one of those things that we have to really evaluate on our life. Don't look at your neighbor at this moment. My question to you is, do you really trust God? Because some of y'all got backup plans for your backup plan. God told you to do something, but you always got four contingencies. He told you not to be dating right now, but you still in the DMs with four guys. Y'all didn't think I was going to come for it. He told you to focus on that one business, but you still doing the side hustles. The truth of the matter is many of our actions are proof we don't trust God. You can say, God, I trust you. You move mountains. But when it comes down to actually obeying him, to actually staying still when he says stay still, or to move when he says to move, our actions expose our trust. Oh, my goodness. And many of us are claiming God, but are acting like he is untrustworthy. The truth of the matter is you shouldn't be here today with your right mind and all the things that God has done in our life. Jimmy, me and you definitely should not be here leading neither one of these churches. Glory to God. But when you begin to trust God with your steps, that's what Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, do what? Acknowledge him and he will direct your path. Some of y'all paths are so jacked up because you don't trust God. You're meeting opposition you were never supposed to even see because you're following the plan that you made instead of the plan that God laid. Okay, can we be hot, humble, open, and transparent? How many people think God should really listen to their plans sometimes? Come on, let's be honest. Sometimes I'll be, and y'all lying. Everybody in this section is lying. You'd be like, God, it would be just a lot easier if you listened to my plan. But God is saying to us in this, if you want to be filled up, you have to trust. So this is my first point. Trust is the prerequisite to overflow. If you want to live in the overflow, you have to trust God. And I'm not talking about no ethereal, trust God, I trust you. No. Give that money. Well, God, if I give that money, then I'm going to be hungry. Trust me. I'm talking about go apologize to them. Well, God, they ugly and they mean. I don't want to apologize. I want to slap them. But you gave me an instruction, so I will trust you. The rest of that verse goes on to really challenge if we want to live in the overflow or not. It says, I pray that God, the source of hope, will fill you completely with joy and peace because you trust him. Then, everybody say then. Then you will overflow with confident hope through the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, I like this one because a lot of people think the Holy Spirit is just for speaking in tongues. But the Holy Spirit actually is your advocate here on earth. And some of y'all just want Jesus. And Jesus said it would be better if I go, because if I go, I'm going to send the Holy Spirit. I'm going to send your advocate. I'm going to send the one who's going to help you day to day on the earth with all of your decisions. He said, if you want to overflow, overflow happens through the Holy Spirit. Now, Pastor Mike, why are you getting up here and being all deep and talking about the Holy Spirit? We just want to hear something that lifts us up. This is going to lift you up because the Holy Spirit is the one that leads and guides you into all, watch this, truth. And most of us believe lies. And so we need somebody to remind us of the truth. And the Holy Spirit is the one that's going to lead you into the overflow. What are you talking about, Pastor Mike? He's going to tell you to do stuff that doesn't make any sense to anybody else. But as you trust and you walk in that path and you do exactly what God says to do, he said, I'll use these foolish things to confound the wise. The very parents that are disowning you, the very company that let you go, the very people that talked bad about you, he said, they will be people that will need you because you're living in the overflow. Hear what I'm saying to you. This ain't for everybody, but this is a prophetic word for about 500 of y'all, that this next season of your life is going to be empowered by the Holy Spirit. So when he speaks, it's not an option. Okay, all right. Overflow It's what God wants to do for you. But you got to remember, the Holy Spirit is the facilitator of the overflow. So that's why I speak in tongues when I wake up. I'm not speaking in tongues out of a ritual. I'm trying to get filled up. Because I got to go out in this job, and something should come out of me that looks different than everything that's in everybody else. But if gossip comes out of me like it comes out of them, where's the Holy Spirit? You got a spirit, it just ain't. What I'm saying to you right now is we have to make a decision to get filled up every day. And the truth of the matter is, y'all come into the fountain Sunday to Sunday to get filled up. And it's not enough. If Pastor Jimmy and this amazing team have to be the ones, or whatever church you go to, have to be the ones to fill you up every time, you will always be dry. This is a message of maturity to my brothers and sisters, that if you leave a church because they don't feed me, that means you don't know how to cook. They don't want to hear this. I had to leave the church because they just wasn't feeding me. Where's your stove? Where is the thing that God placed on your heart that you cook in Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday? We thank God for 7-day conference, but this is not every week. But do you know you can have a revival every day you wake up? Oh, y'all didn't hear me? I said, did you know you can have a revival every day you wake up? That you could be filled up to overflow. Okay, so what I'm telling you right now is that the Holy Spirit is the facilitator of the overflow. And Pastor Mike, why are you talking about this? Because I want to teach you about God's nature. Overflow is the principle of God's presence. When God shows up, overflow shows up. Every time that he comes into the scene, there's always more than enough. You can look all through the Bible. Y'all remember the story where the disciples got hungry when Jesus was doing a mass crusade, and there's about 5,000 men out there. They counted 20,000 people, and the disciples came to Jesus and was like, Jesus, we need to let these people go. They need to go get some food from KFC or something, because we got to leave here. And Jesus looks at the disciples and says, you feed them. And the disciples like, we don't got nothing. He was like, well, there's a little boy got a little fish pack, 2 fish and 5 loaves that we stole from him because we was hungry too. I think we can do that. And Jesus said, that's enough. Sit the people down in groups of 50. Sits all these people down. He blesses and breaks it. And they start serving all these people. The miracle of the fish and the loaves, everybody focuses on the fact that it multiplied. But the truth of the matter is, you find God's character in the fact that there were 12 baskets left over. Somebody shout at me, overflow. Why in the world would God take not enough, make it enough, and then leave more than, enough? Because he wanted to convince you of his character. When I show up, there will always be overflow. And some of you have not been able to believe it because you think your God is as big as your situation. You think your situation is bigger than your God. But I came to serve notice to every lie and devil in South and in Africa, in Nigeria, in all the neighboring countries, and let you know that my God is bigger. 12 baskets left over. People are saying, why was there 12? I think many theologians have different ideas of why. But do you know how many disciples there were? Which tells me, Pastor Jimmy, that God will never let you distribute a miracle. That he won't let you walk away with the spoils of it. And some of y'all have been serving God and doing the things he told you to do, and you've been saying, God, what about me? Everybody else is getting their fish and loaves. Everybody else's family is getting fed. What are you doing? And I said, you serve the God of the overflow. I promise you there's a basket with your name on it somewhere. I said, I promise you there is a blessing, a basket, a breakthrough with your name on it. If you believe it, give God a shout of praise in this place. Shout at me, overflow. This is the nature of our God. Have you ever thought about it? That even in his first miracle, turning water into wine, that was a miracle of overflow. I imagine in the movie of my mind, Mary was like, Jesus, they done ran out of wine over here. Do the miracle. Jesus says, woman, my time has not yet come. She said, boy, please. And look at the Bible, she said, do whatever he says. And he took what was gone. I need you to, the water ran out. So a miracle would have been the water being filled back up. Water ran out, water filled back up. Everybody drink water. But because our God specializes in overflow, he turns the water into wine. And then they taste it and say, oh my God, this the best. Why, when God shows up, does he not do the bare minimum? Because it's in his nature to move in the, somebody shout at me, overflow. Pastor Mike, why are you giving me all these examples? Because I want you to know he's no respecter of person. If he could find somebody in this service or watching online that would actually believe that your not enough situation can turn into overflow like this, he may be able to do a miracle that nobody will take credit for except him. Lazarus, I'm just giving you a couple case studies so you know that our God specializes in the overflow. Lazarus dies. And Jesus could have been like, you know what? I'll do the funeral. That would have been nice of him. It's over. What does he do? He doesn't just heal him. He resurrects him. He takes a dead situation, a dead man, and says, I want you to come back to life again. That is a God who specializes in the over. Y'all gonna make me where I got to sit down. Because y'all, Adam and Eve in the garden. Now, I always wonder, why didn't God just put two trees there? That would have been more. One tree you can eat from, one you can't. But the Bible goes into great detail telling us that it was an entire mass landscape of more than enough than they needed. They were living in Eden in the overflow, which lets me know that you can have more than enough around you and still be focused on the wrong thing. Oh my gosh. How in the world are they sitting with all the fruit ever made around them? And they only can focus on one apple that the Lord told them not to eat? Golly. Could it be that many of you are in a season of overflow, but because of the distraction of the enemy, you are focusing on the one or two things God says you can't have. You can't have her. Get away from her. That ain't your wife. Uh-oh. That ain't your business. That ain't your, get away. And so much around you, but you can't even see it. Because you're focused on what the enemy is telling you is the thing God doesn't want you to have. Our God specializes in the overflow. And that's why I believe God wants it for you. That's why Ephesians 3:20 says, now unto him who is able to do immeasurably exceeding above all you can ask, think, or what's that other word? But it's according to the power that works inside of. So you're the holdup to the overflow. He said, I'm choosing to make my glory and power known on this earth through you. And if you stop what I can do because of what you've seen, you're capping the overflow. Well, my mama never did it. My dad never did it. Nobody from my village, my tribe, my country has done it. Forget all that. Because we serve a God who is coming to let you know that this is a new season for you to live in the overflow. Somebody say, I'm living in the overflow. All right. See, the reason why I have to give this to you, because some of y'all's situation is about to change very quickly. Jimmy, I don't know if they understand what this conference is doing. It's actually giving every person what I see in the spirit is a metamorphosis. That they were caterpillars doing a lot of work with 100 legs. And God this week has put you in a spiritual cocoon. And by this time next week, people are coming out with wings. I'm talking, you're going to be flying places you could have never been before. Where are the people that believe by faith that there's another level for you to go to? But that's why you have to embrace the idea that God wants you to live in the overflow. A caterpillar will never see what a butterfly sees. A caterpillar will never be able to experience flight with the butterfly locked inside of them the whole time. Why did I come here? I needed you to see that there's another level of living. There's some things that your whole family been caterpillars and y'all pride yourself in being caterpillars. But God said, but I chose you to have wings. And nobody would stay long enough in the cocoon of the spirit to actually get their wings. Yes, it's isolating for a season. Yes, they saying you crazy. Yes, they're talking about, oh, she thinks she different. Baby, bye. I'm about to fly. I don't even got to. Somebody by faith. Hey. There is about to be a change. Ooh, I feel that thing. Some of y'all gonna be walking around your apartment and you're gonna be like, you know what? Mm-mm. This is temporary. I'm getting my win by faith. Your kids gonna start tripping. You say, not always, not always. I feel that thing. The seeds that you've planted have qualified you for butterfly status. And this is why God's saying, it's me that's going to cause you to do what you never thought you could do. But don't forget about me when you start flying. Uh-oh. See, the reason I have to give you this is because overflow, watch this, write this down. The overflow comes with options. See, it's dangerous because the reason some of y'all pray is because you ain't got no options. The reason some of y'all single is because you ain't got no options. The reason some of us do it, but what happens to somebody when they have options? The true nature of who they are begins to show. And when you begin to live in the overflow of resources, the overflow of connections, the overflow of favor, it comes with options. The question is, will you still praise God when you don't have to? Some of y'all praising in here because you believing for your lights to stay on next week. But when you own the light company, then why do you praise? And many of you, you have not ascended to the level that God wants you because he knows that the relationship with him will be lost as soon as you reach overflow. Ooh-wee. And tonight I came to warn you that as quickly as God changes your season, don't change your discipline. Let him change the season, but don't change your discipline. Still get up and come to Thursday morning. Still join and come early for prayer. Still do that Bible study that God told you to do. Still represent and represent him wherever you go. Because what most people do is get the blessing and forget about the blesser. And tonight, I believe there's a galvanizing of a body of people, a remnant of people that are going to say, God, I will live in the overflow, but I will never forget the presence of God. When options come, that's when people start missing the mark and they end up squandering what God has prepared for them. But not in this room, not at this church, and not at this conference. Amen? So this is what I need you to know. If you're going to live in the overflow, watch this. You got to stay in position. You got to stay in position. The power of overflow is in staying in position. I was talking to one of my friends who rides bikes. And he rides bikes like competitively, like fast. They're going 30, 40 miles an hour on these bikes. And I don't know if y'all have ever seen the Tour de France and different things like that. But what ends up happening in those situations is there's about four or five guys that get in a line and they start biking really, really, really fast. And they're going so fast. And the thing that I found out from talking to him, because I think riding a bike that fast is silly, so I'm never going to do that. But as I was talking to him, he said the person in third or fourth position is the one who's going to win the race. And I said, what? He said, it's because they intentionally picked the person who's going to win, and everybody else is cutting the wind for them. So there are people that are designed to be in front for a season. But the whole reason they're in front is to make way for the person that's third or fourth back to be able to, at the last minute, be able to come up to the front. Because when you're in third and fourth position, they call it drafting. When you're in third or fourth position, you're using 70% less energy to go as fast as everybody else. And the problem with most of us is nobody will stay in position long enough to see the victory at the end. Because to start the race in third or fourth position, watch what you have to be: humble. And everybody want to be the big dog on campus. Everybody want to be the boss. And God said, what if I've created humility as the tool that's going to allow you to walk into another level of overflow and not forget where you came from? Today, if you're going to live in the overflow, you have to stay in position. Some of y'all ready to move churches. God didn't say that. You just got offended. And the reason God allowed you to get offended is so you could work out that thing in your heart, because it's not just stopping you here. It's stopping you everywhere. You're prideful. And what he wants you to do is be humble. It's quiet in here. It got real quiet. No, you can't sing the solo, but I can sing. It ain't your season yet. Well, I'm going to go to a place where they appreciate my gift. And what you didn't know is the husband you've been praying for is 2 weeks away. But you got out of position. Now you crying and praying, God, I thought you said. He said, it wasn't me. I'm begging the body of Christ in my generation, stay in position. Because if you want to see fruit in your life, a potted plant does not grow to its full capacity. Because it's in a place that is a small container, but it needs to get planted into soil. And many of you under the sound of my voice, because of the lack of humility, because of the presence of pride, we have not allowed God to help us stay in position. Even as this church is in a major transition, 6 months of transition, many people have voted about staying in position. And today I'm coming to prophetically let you know that your humility in this next season is going to be the key to your overflow. Nobody believes it except four people in the back, but I'm telling you right now, mark my words. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, stay in position. Now look at the neighbor you didn't like as much and say, stay in position. Somebody say, I'm living in the overflow. Okay, so this is what I'm gonna give you in my last 10 minutes. How to stay in position for the overflow. First thing you need to do, write this down. Pick your source. Pick your source. is God going to be your source or not? Because for many of us in this room, we are still undecided about who our real source is. For some of you, your job is your source. If your job calls you, if they tell you to do something, if God tells you, it's like, well, God, don't know if I'm really feeling that. Check with me next week. I made a decision that God was going to be my source. Everything else is a resource. Somebody say, God is my source. Say it with faith. God is my source. Everything else is a resource. That means God can redirect it. He can renew it, refresh it, redo it. But whatever I get, I know my source is God. So if you're going to stay in the overflow, you have to pick your source. If I had a water hose, a gardening hose, I would bring it out here and I would pick it and I would turn it on and I would just spray water in this whole section and in that section because I'm crazy like that. And some of y'all are like, my wig. But it would get the point across really good. But the thing about something being plugged up to a source, it would never run out. And most of us are picking sources that have temporary fulfillment. But like he told the woman that was at the well, he said, do you want to have a drink from a well that never runs dry? When you pick God as your source, you got to understand is he doesn't run out of options. God can choose to bless you, to change you, to transform you any way he wants to. Because he's the source. Stop going to sources that need to get refilled. So if you go to your husband or your wife as your source, at some point they got to get refilled. If you put all your energy into your kids and your business and all, at some point all of that, you ain't never had to encourage God. When the last time you had to get God up to really bless his people? He's the source that does not run out. And tonight all over this room, I believe there's going to be a decision that I'm going to live in the overflow, and the source of the overflow is God. Somebody shout, God. God is my source. Not this church, not my bank account, not... God is my, if God isn't the source, how do people with $1 billion trying to figure out how to breathe 2 more days? Because he's the source of life. The money can't fix what's going, how you got all of that and don't got no peace. Bentleys, Range Rovers, G-Wagons, no peace. It's because they put their faith in the wrong source. But somebody say, I'm going to pick my source. What's his name? God. Come on, somebody say that. So how do I position myself for overflow? I pick my source. It's God. Okay? And this is what I need everybody to see. Elijah, in 1 Kings chapter 18, he was standing out there with the prophets of Baal, and he was basically telling everybody, choose you this day who you going to serve. If God be God, serve him. If Baal is God, serve him. Today I came to this beautiful conference to just say, stop being fickle. Choose. Is God really going to be your source? Because if he is, go all the way in. Let's see if it really works. Let's not be lukewarm in any capacity of our lives. And when you get to this point of the understanding, that's when you get to point number two. If I'm going to stay in the overflow, I need to pick my size. See, I pick my source, but then I need to pick my size. Can I get those cups? Did they have those cups that I had? Anybody had them cups? I think they're in the back or they're somewhere around here. Let me see. It's so crazy that a lot of people are talking about overflow. A lot of people that fill my cup, Lord, fill it up, Lord. Your cup little. You're yelling overflow. Look at me. They just gonna find a cup. They're gonna find a cup. If they don't find a cup, it'll still work right here. Okay, you got me? Yeah, just thank you. Yeah. Just keep that right there. You yelling overflow in this. Pass me that water right there. Just pass me that. Just throw it to me. Throw it to me. Yeah. All right. You yelling overflow. Lord, I just thank you that you're filling me up, Lord. You're doing more than I. Oh, my God. Hey, Shantayalabaski. Ooh, I'm full, Lord. You're filling me up, Lord. Ooh, and I overflow. How many people can this quench their thirst? Not even mine. Could it be that your faith to believe God is too small? You're yelling overflow, but the cup is too little. Today I'm asking you, don't just pick your source to live in the overflow. Pick your size. What level of faith are you going to walk in? Are you walking in a level of faith, Lord, just pay my bills? Or are you walking in a level of faith, God, let me be able to pay somebody else's bills? Pick your size. Y'all don't hear me in this place. I said pick your size. This is overflow, but it's too little for all of us to be able to get our needs met. I believe tonight some of y'all going to change the vessel. Some of y'all going to be like, you know what? I need to upgrade my faith. I need to go to something that got a little more. Matter of fact, I need more water. Come on, throw me some more water, huh? Some of y'all need to get in a place where you're saying, what I've been having is not enough. I've expanded. Watch this word, capacity. Your capacity has grown. And many people in this room, by faith, your capacity is growing. I feel it right now. Your capacity is growing right now. Receive this right now. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I thank you that in this moment, capacity is growing. Capacity to think. The capacity to be able to handle. The capacity to be able to steward. The capacity to be able to share. Expand our minds. Give us new capacity to be able to think critically, to be able to forgive. Come on, I need y'all to hear me. Give us new capacity. I prophesy that by this time next year, the capacity would have grown so much in the people of this house and in this region, Father, there would be room for more. Somebody shout overflow. But Pastor Jimmy, for the vision that y'all have here, you need people that walking around with vessels like this. I'm talking about, because still with this cup, it only can make me satisfied. But when I put it in a punch bowl, and watch this, who got water in the room? Come put some water in this. Come on, just come on up here. See what ends up happening. Come on. Yeah, come on, sis. What ends up happening is when everybody begins to pour what they have into the vessel. Ah. When anybody begins, come on, wherever you're at, no matter how old, no matter how young, I want y'all to see it prophetically. Whenever you start to pour, when the babies start to pour, when the young people, when the old people begin to pour, listen, what ends up happening? Ah, all right. Stop. Hold on, stop. Now everybody listen. Everybody freeze right where you're at. Freeze. Don't go back to your seat. Freeze. Y'all make room so the camera can see this. We're at the point right now. I need everybody to hear me. We're at the point right now that if one more drop comes into this, we will be living in the... I'm going to say it one more time. In just a matter of seconds, because everybody brought what they had, this container that almost seemed too big has now become a place where I got to say, hold up, wait, and people still got water. So, golly. So what I'm believing, man of God, is that we won't settle for this. I'm talking about now pour.
this is going to be the season that we are going to be filled up and we're going to be able to pour. Somebody shout at me, overflow. I want you to see what's happening. I love you, brother. I want you to see what's happening. I want you to see what's happening. Now listen. Come on. Come on. That man said, I'm not going to let my ailment keep me from pouring my water in. In the name of Jesus, I thank you for healing all over his body in Jesus' name. Oh, I feel the presence of God right here, y'all. If you have a heavenly language, begin to speak in that thing right now. Lift it up all over this place. This is a prophetic sign, Jimmy. This is a prophetic sign. This right here is what fountain. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, whoa. The name of this church is Fountain of Life. This is a prophetic sign of this next season in this church. I feel the presence of God. Pick a bigger size. Get more faith. Believe God can do it. Everything he showed you, he's able. Oh, I feel the presence of God in this place. I dare you to take 10 seconds and give God praise for the overflow that's coming. And guess what? Guess what? While we're pouring this water, there are people in the audience saying it's a waste of water. Even after all this revelation, they could have used that water. You take long showers. This prophetic picture with the mama bringing her son up, from the sippy cup. Uh-oh. This is generational. Look at this, baby. Baby, pour it right in here. Baby, pour the water in there. I declare overflow for this baby all the days of his life. I dare you to shout for the generational blessings. Somebody shout at me, overflow. Shout it again, overflow. Thank you, Father. Everybody's standing. We're about to end, but I feel the presence of God in here. Not only do you have to pick your source, somebody say God. And then we got to pick our size. Somebody say, that's faith. But then you got to pick your story. See, you were born into a story, but the way your story ends determines how you and God come at it. None of us could choose how we were born, where we were born, what's happening. But now you have a responsibility to stay in position. To stay steady in your position. And you get to pick your story. Somebody say, I get to pick my story. Let me prove it to you. Because we serve the God of the overflow. Y'all remember the story of Elijah and Elisha? And Elisha knew that his master was about to transition to heaven. And remember he said, hey, I want the double portion of your anointing. Or another way it could be said, I want the overflow. I've been walking with you all this time. I want the overflow. And what did Elijah tell him? He said, if you are with me, or another way that could be said, if you're in position, if you stay in position, when I ascend, you can have the overflow. And just a few moments later, the Bible says they're walking, and my man just hits a straight, like, levitation to heaven. And because Elisha was in position, because he took the right stance, because he was humble enough to stay there, he got the double portion of the anointing. To the point where the men was trying to search for Elijah's body, and the double portion of it was standing right there with him. Everybody won't be able to recognize your anointing. Y'all better stop looking for a clap from mama, daddy, and all of them. They are blinded to what God is doing in your life. But soon they will see and be benefactors of thee. Pastor Jimmy, you don't got to prove that you're the right pastor for this church. Not another day. Because the fruit of your life and this church will begin to overflow onto the streets right out here. I dare you, if you believe that by faith, to give God a shout of praise. And I hear this prophetically for both of you. God is going to give you both the humility to make the bridges that they won't make. They're not coming. So there's leaders and pastors and dignitaries that aren't coming because it would take too much humility. But God has made you a man and a woman of stature, and this is the word I keep hearing, meekness. That's power under control. Power under the control of the Holy Spirit. And God's going to give you wisdom of when to invite, who to call, where to go have coffee, what to show up to. And God is going to create a unity in this city among churches that has not been here in 100 years. I hear this right now by the Spirit. There is a unity coming to the body of Christ, because for what the corruption and principalities y'all have to face, you got to face it with a team of people. That's why there's not been much headway made, because it's little factions fighting by themselves. But God is going to use this church, a fountain. A fountain of life, to create bridges so that the kingdom can overflow. Somebody give God praise right there. Elisha picked his story. He told him, I want the double portion, and stayed in position long enough to get the overflow. My question to everybody under the sound of my voice is, will you stay in position? Will you be faithful? Will you pick your shores and pick your size? Somebody say big. It's got to be bigger. 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 Look at your neighbor and say, it's got to be bigger. Yeah. Come on, tell them, it's got to be bigger. Dream bigger. Believe bigger. It's got to be bigger. Not one song, the whole album. It's got to be bigger. It's got to be the book, not just the essay. It's got to be bigger. It's not just buying a car, it's giving the car away. It's got to be bigger. And pick your story. And today I believe God's changing people's story. How many people under the sound of my voice, I'm 5 minutes over, how many people from the faith that has been spoken in this room is going to make a decision to live in the overflow? The work gets easier now, because we're not going through mindsets that are broken. It is God's will for you, man of God, woman of God, child of God, for you to live in the overflow. Watch this. I need everybody to hear me say this. Empty is the opposite of overflow. I was driving my car the other day, and I ran out of charge because I had an electric car. My wife sent me on an assignment I did not know I was going for. Thank you, woman of God. And it was a lot further than I thought it was going to be. And I ran out of charge 20 miles away from where my next charging station was. If you ever want to hear a man of God pray, I was hitting the dashboard, praying. I had my kids in the back. Plead the blood. Like, I was, because I didn't want to get stuck on the highway. 20 miles later, I made it to the charging station. And I begin to shout. And God says, stop. Instead of shouting, make a decision. I said, what? He said, you are about to praise me because you barely made it. Make a decision, you'll never be that close to empty again. Tonight, I believe prophetically, some of y'all have just been using the last bit of strength you had, the last bit of love you had, and you praise God every time you just make it. But tonight is the night to make a decision. I will never live that close to empty ever again. I'm going to fill up with the word of God. I'm going to fill up with this presence. I'm going to fill up by serving. I'm going to fill up so I never have to be that dry again. If that's you in this room, Pastor Jimmy, I don't know if this is protocol, but I feel that I got to pray. I need people to make a step of faith. If you know that there is an area of your life that has been completely dry, but you want God to fill it up, I want you to get down to this altar right now. Right now, quickly. The water can still be there. Come on. Y'all just don't get in the water. And if you do, you're living in the overflow. Okay. Come on, just quickly. Yep. I feel the presence. I need the church to begin to pray. Come on, just come with your hands lifted because I'm not going to touch you. God is. Woo. Yeah, it's a new day for every person. Every dry area is about to overflow. Do you hear me? Every dry area, it's fine. Make room. Stand in the aisle. This is about to be a miracle of God. Pastor Jimmy, there is a miracle that's about to happen in this room. Begin to ask God to fill that area up. Come on, right now. If it's a lack of love, it's been isolation, it's been poor finances, poor thinking, begin to ask God to fill it up right now. Come on, right now. He's going to fill you up. Yeah. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, Father. Come on, this is for the desperate, the prideful. You don't have to come, but this is for the desperate tonight. Every empty area, every place where I've been going to substances and sex and pornography and money to be able to fill me up. Today, I make a decision to divorce it. I need you to pray right now. I decide every place I've been going to gossip, every place I've been going to get temporary fulfillment, tonight it's over. And I'm going to the source, Jehovah Jireh, the God who will provide. Father, we declare and we decree right now that the power of God is flowing throughout this room and even online. And it's moving us, oh Rabataya Rabasha, into a place of overflow. Father, I thank you in the name of Jesus. Whoa, whoa, Rabasa. I thank you in the name of Jesus that you are moving us from where we've been into the future of where you have us. Cry out to your Father right there. Come on, y'all. This is not about a man. This is about the source, our God. He's filling you up. You'll never go that empty again. From the inside out, Father. Generation, every person that's in the aisle, every person generationally, Father, from our head to our feet, let us live in the overflow of your presence, of your love, of your kindness, of your grace. Yeah, it's happening. This is real ministry. It's raining down. It's coming down right now. It's not about you having an experience with a man. It's about God speaking to you right now. Do the work, God. Do the work, God. Do the work, God. Let this be a line of demarcation, Father God. No one in this room will ever be the same. From the top of their head to the soles of their feet, Father God. Thank you, Father God, for an overflow. Overflow of ideas. Overflow of wisdom. And overflow, Father, of freedom. Come on, if you're in the balcony, lift your hands up in this place. God, we want an overflow. If we've been filled up, we want to be filled up more, God. And we say Yahweh, Yah, reign over and take over. This is the cry of the overflow. Say Yahweh. Say Yahweh.
Reign over
and take over.
Take over.
Just one more time, hands lifted all over. Say Yahweh.
Yahweh. Woo. Yahweh.
Do what only you can do, God.
Reign over.
Every area of my life, God.
Take over.
Just one more time, say Yahweh.
Yahweh.
For everybody at the altar, lift your hands. I'm about to read this scripture over you. I pray that God, the source of hope, will fill you completely with joy and peace because you trust Him. Then you will overflow with confident hope through the power of the Holy Spirit. If you receive it right now, give God a shout of praise in this place. Oh, come on. I said give God the source of all of our strength, the God who reigns over. Hallelujah. Just lift it up one more time. Say Yahweh. Lift it up. Say
Yahweh.
Reign over.
Reign over.
We want more of you, God.
Take over.
No music, just say Yahweh, lift it up.
Yahweh.
Woo!
Yahweh.
Reign over and take over. Come on, just one more time, lift it up, say
Yahweh.
Hallelujah.
Take over.
Whatever you want to do, whatever you want to do, have your way. Have your way. Whatever you want to do, whatever you want to do. Have your way. Have your way. Whatever you want to do. Whatever you want to do.
Come on, y'all.
Have your way. Have your way.
Make that the cry of your heart. Say it.
Whatever you want to do.
I'm yours, God.
Whatever you want to do.
Whatever you want to do, I'm yours, God.
Have your way.
Woo.
Have your way.
There's another part that says like this. It says, I will wait with my faith. It's not over. It's not over. Come on, they that wait upon the Lord. Somebody say, I will wait.
I will wait.
With my faith.
With my faith.
It's not over. Somebody should be grateful for that. It's
not over.
Come on, your situation is still working. I will wait.
I will wait.
With my faith.
With my faith.
It's not over. God's gonna do what He promised. He's not playing you. Just one more time. Said, I will wait. I'll stay in position, God.
It's not over.
It's not over.
Not over.
Last time, Yahweh, lift it up. Everybody say, Yahweh. Say,
Yahweh.
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 and take over.
Take over.
Say Yahweh. Woo. God, I feel your presence in this place. And take over. So take my heart and mold it. Take my mind. Transform it. And take my will. Conform it.
Woo.
To yours.
To yours.
To yours. Oh Lord. Cause you are Alpha and just sing that one more time. Woo.
You are
He knows the beginning from the end. That means he's working it out in the middle.
We
from the bottom of your heart, can we say it one more time? We give you all the glory. I need you to say it. Come on, say it. I overflow. This is your prayer for the rest of your life. My family, my business, every dark place in my mind, every place where I try to go hide, all the negative thinking, all my pride. All my pride, whoa. Take it out, God, and fill me up. Hey. I need your help on the next. Say, fill me up till I overflow. Say,
fill me up.
Hey, hey, somebody say,
till I overflow.
I want to run over.
I wanna run over.
lift it up from your heart.
Still doing it.